Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas, and today we continue our six-part series on gravity forms, and we're going to cover conditional logic today, which is something you probably didn't even know necessarily existed. You didn't know to Google it, but you're about to be blown away by how cool it is and the fun things you can do inside of a form. I want to give shout outs really quickly to our incredible partners that help us in our classes here at WebTegrity and our classes online. WP Engine offers incredible WordPress hosting, awesome security, great staging environments, fantastic customer support. WP Elevation offers really cool tracks for freelancers that use WordPress. And then WP 101 is going to be more incredible video tutorials that are helping you learn basics to advanced stuff with WordPress. So check them out and let them know that Corey Ashton sent you their way. I'd appreciate that. Thank you very much. All right, so we're talking about gravity forms. I'm going to drop down here, shrink down just a little bit so you can kind of still see me, but I want you to focus here on the form. I've created a form with gravity forms that has a name, email, and then this drop down option here for what people might be needing help with, and then they can fill out a little bit more detail and click submit, right? Very simple form that we've created. But what if when somebody chose demo request, I had a way of asking them to choose a date? But I didn't want the date option to appear if somebody was just choosing tech support, right? So demo request, how can I get something conditionally if this is chosen to appear? It's called conditional logic, and it's simple. It's out of the box features inside of WordPress, inside of Gravity Forms rather. All right, so I'm in my form. I have my name, my email, my subject line with my drop down option, and my optional message. This is an advanced field that we want to add because I want to do a date picker. So I'm going to click date. You know, in Gravity Forms, by default, it takes it to the bottom of the whole lineup. So you have to drag it up to whatever order you want it in. So right after this subject, if somebody chooses the demo request, I want this to appear. So I'm going to open it up, and I'm going to say select a date. And then I'll say here something like, what day is best for you to see a demo, right? And then we have a couple options here. No icon next to this, or maybe we want a calendar icon, which I do like that, or you can even put a custom icon. You can choose a different format of date if you'd like, whatever you're more familiar with. And then we do want this to be required. But again, we don't want this to appear if somebody is just choosing tech support, right? So what I want to do is go over to this third tab here, which is advanced. Down here toward the bottom of that little box is something called Enable Conditional Logic. Clicking on that, look at the goodies that appear. So we want to say show this field if all match the following. If your subject is demo request. What? How cool is this? All right, so I'm going to update the form. Let me show you it in action, okay? And we're going to just leave that there. Let me click refresh on this page. So now if I'm come here to this page and I'm gonna fill in, oh, it's still refreshing. It's thinking about refreshing. All right, fill in my name, fill in my email. I'm gonna choose demo request and look what just appeared. How groovy cool is this? And then I have an option to choose the date, add my message, and click submit. All right, how amazing is that? Get as creative as you possibly can with what those can do. You can even hide the submit button where every field has to be filled out and then the submit button will appear. It's just so cool, so much you can do. It's just amazing. And since this was such a short tutorial on those really cool conditional logic options, and every field has that in the advanced area down at the bottom, I'm gonna show you how to do a 2 to 3 page form. So if you have a very, very lengthy form, and you want to break it into multiple steps where it's not so overwhelming to people. Maybe it's a job application and you want to have people fill out their personal information first, and then click next, and then they go to another area that has all of their past job history information. You can do that inside of Gravity Forms. It's so amazing. So all you're going to do is you can create all of your fields that you want, and then you'd want to do a, actually it's right here. You can do a section and put like a header over it if you wanted to, or you can say page. Watch this. So start the page here, and then end of page here, and then what goes on the next page. So you can have something else added there, and this goes on the next page. How cool is this? So if we want it to just say next, or next page, or final page, or last page, whatever you want it to be, you can change the verbiage on here. You can come up here to the very first one and say, do you want this to be a progress bar, or do you want it to be in steps, or maybe none? We're not going to show them at all that it's a two, three, or three page thing. It has some preset styles and colors that you can do. You can name the pages, so we can name the first page personal info, and we can name the second page job history, right? And that way, nobody's getting overwhelmed with a really incredibly long form, but you're still being able to get all of your information. So you can display completed progress bar on confirmation, and you can say completed, or you can say congrats completed, or you can put whatever you want. Get as personal as you can in there so that people feel engaged, right? This is going to be a two page basically, right? So let's go, I'm just playing around here. Let's go back to the demo really quickly and show you the break in it. So our submit button should go away, and it should say next now, right? To take us over to that next field. And here's my progress bar, so I can fill out my information. You see it says personal info right here. I fill out my information. When I'm done with all the, let's just go and fill it out really quickly. Corey, and we're gonna do Corey at Webtegrity, right? .com, and we already have our subject, and this is optional. So it really doesn't matter for me to fill this in or not. And I'm gonna click next. And now it dynamically takes me on to that second page, keeping all of this in one complete email coming to me and untitled. So this is gonna be anything I want, and then click submit. And now it should tell me success and do whatever I've told it to do, which is I've told it to go ahead and take me to my page confirmation, which if you don't know how to set up confirmations, be sure to check out our last video because I showed you how to do notifications and confirmations. How cool is that? You can set up as many pages as you want. I wouldn't really do a whole lot because people do tend to get fear of forms and they get bored with them or they get irritated by them. So get enough information just to grab that lead and know for sure that you're getting the information you need to touch back with that person. All right? How cool is Gravity Forms? I hope you're nerding out with me. I'm pretty nerding out. All right, over here in this little corner, I've got a little box that looks like a play box. Click that to subscribe to our channels because we're gonna bring on some more Gravity Forms tutorials in the next couple of weeks. You don't wanna miss it. We're gonna talk about add-ons, how to make a shopping cart out of this thing. It's gonna be amazing, blow your mind. I'll catch you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye-bye, y'all.